her memoir, Takari wrote that she was primarily raised by her grandmother because Jackie was allegedly too busy hustling and dealing with men. Takari added, "I like to think I did not live with my parents in my early years because of their lifestyle, but truth be told, it was because they were just selfish as hell." The feds eventually came for her dad, and in her book, Takari alludes to Jackie ratting him out. He served 3 years behind bars, and their substance empire allegedly came crashing down. In 1992, Doug was in his hometown of Seattle when a mutual friend introduced him to Jackie at a sports bar. At the time, Doug was still a student at Pepperdine University. Now, there are two versions of this story. According to Takari, Doug was interested in Jackie, but Jackie allegedly told him he needed to get his money up first. But according to Doug, he asked for Jackie's number, and she gave it to him, but he didn't call her. A few weeks later, they ran into each other at a party, and Doug asked her to dance. He told the Seattle Times, "The music has never stopped." After getting picked up by the Seattle Supersonics in the 1992 NBA draft, Doug was immediately traded to the Lakers. 3 months later, Jackie was pregnant. According to Takari, Doug and Jackie weren't even in an official relationship at the time, and Jackie was allegedly dealing with other men. Doug's mom reportedly questioned the paternity of the unborn child so much it created a wedge. Jackie gave birth to their daughter Chantel and raised her in Seattle while Doug played ball in LA. Once a paternity test proved Doug was the baby's daddy, he reportedly moved Jackie and their newborn to LA. Takari stayed behind with her grandmother for a bit in Seattle until Doug and Jackie sent for Takari and her grandmother to move to LA. During a season 2 episode of Basketball Wives, Chantel alleged that Jackie was emotionally and mentally abusive to Takari and would tease her about her weight.
"For years, my sister and I, we didn't speak to each other. No relationship whatsoever, because she always played us against each other. She's fat and she's black and you're skinny and you need to stay in shape and you're the model."
Takari also confirmed these allegations. One day, while sitting in the driveway of their home, Doug said he received several messages from God. His purpose in life became clear, and he decided right then and there that he wanted to marry Jackie. He proposed in 1996, and they got married 3 days later. Jackie told the Huff Post there were a lot of mishaps on their wedding day. They lost the ring, Doug's tuxedo ripped because it was too tight, and as they walked down the winding staircase to meet the minister, she kept telling Doug, "If you want to, you can change your mind about this. We can still have a party. You don't have to marry me." But Doug went through with it, and they've renewed their vows every year since then. They also welcomed a son named Dougie Jr. Doug bounced around to several teams in the NBA, and attendees started noticing that Doug would make hand signals toward the rafters. Initially, people thought he was calling out plays to his teammates, but it was later revealed that he was using his hand signals to communicate with Jackie. According to the New York Times, he often made the same hand signals up to 50 times per game. He told the newspaper, "That's just to let my wife know I love her, and she and family are bigger than basketball."